children, welcome to the science class. Shall we start today's class with a recap? What did you learn in the last class? In the last class, we learned about various agricultural research institutes, such as Indian Agricultural Research Institutes, Indian Council of Agricultural Research, Krishi Vigyan Kendra, and these institutes develop various techniques to improve food production. Foliar spray, AM technology, vermiwash, and panchagavya are the techniques developed by the above institutes. Okay children, now let's move on to the today's topic. Our farmers use various chemical fertilizers and pesticides to enrich soil nutrients and control pests in order to increase food production. But these chemical fertilizers and pesticides give negative effects rather than positive effects. So, the farmers are encouraged to use various biocontrol methods to control pests in crop production. I just recall what are pests. Some insects, mites, and even some microbes cause diseases in crops and affect the yield. Such organisms are called as pests. Instead of chemical pesticides and fertilizers, farmers use some organisms and chemicals obtained from some plants as pesticides and fertilizers, and these methods are called as biocontrol methods. Bio means life. As living organisms are used in this method, these methods are called as biocontrol methods. What are biocontrol methods? Biocontrol methods are the methods of controlling pests and plant diseases using other organisms. They can be used in the form of biopesticides, biorepellents, biopredators, and biofertilizers. Biopesticides kill the pests, biorepellents keep away the pests, biopredators feed on pests, and biofertilizers enrich the soil fertility. Now let us see one by one. First, we can learn about biopesticides. Biopesticides are living organisms or their derived parts. They are used as biocontrol agents and they protect crops against insect pests. Example, entomopathogenic viruses, Bacillus thuringiensis, a bacteria, entomofungal pathogens, protozoans, and nematodes. Fungal biopesticides control diseases caused by fungi such as wilt, rusting of leaves, and root. Example, Trichoderma viride, a fungi used as the biopesticide. The next one is the bacterial biopesticide. Bacillus thuringiensis control Lepidoptera. They attack cotton and maize. Panchagavya, leaves decoction of some plants are also the examples of bacterial biopesticides. Biorepellent. The biorepellents are organic compounds obtained from some plants. They are used to repel the pests from stored grains. Example, azadiractin obtained from seeds of neem and dried margosa leaves, one of the earliest pesticides. The next one is biopredators. Biopredators are naturally occurring insects that use pests for feeding or multiplication. Example, the Chrysos species and Manoculus species are called as the biopredators. They feed on the pests like aphids, white flies, cotton bollworms, and leaf insects. Biofertilizer. These are organisms which can bring about soil nutrient enrichment. The main source of biofertilizer is cyanobacteria, azospirillum, rhizobium, and certain fungi. what is the role of these microbes in soil nutrient enrichment? These microbes live freely in the soil. They fix atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds in the soil and make it available to the crops like cereals, millets, fruits, and vegetables. Have you observed the root nodules of leguminous plants? If not, look at the video and observe the root nodules of leguminous plants. These root nodules are the shelters of rhizobium bacteria. The rhizobium bacteria have the ability to fix the atmospheric nitrogen in the soil in the form of nitrates and enrich the soil. Students, we have successfully completed the lesson. What do you understand from this lesson? From this lesson, we understand that we must support farmers as they supply food to all of us. Another important thing is to lead a healthy and happy life, we should buy and consume organic foods only. Thank you, children.